the key benefits of an NGS approach versus traditional approaches such as IHC or FISH is that you could combine all of the tests you would have done before into one single test that can be done rapidly and give you the same answers quicker and with the same resolution. It's a lot quicker, it's just as accurate, it simplifies the laboratory workflow, it allows us to concentrate our skills on the science that matters to us, and it gives us more information than we would have had access to previously. The advantage of this test is it's an all-in-one test, so you can do many of the things that would formerly take dozens of tests, for instance combining IHC, FISH and Sanger sequencing can all be done in this one test and give you the same readout in a short amount of time. I think there's a lot of value about consolidating other tests into NGS-based tests. It simplifies the laboratory workflow, it allows us to concentrate our skills on the science that matters to us, and it allows rapid turnaround in scientific inquiry. I think using a comprehensive NGS panel has two benefits. The first obviously is calling tumour mutational burden, and that is obviously a more and more important biomarker of many disease processes. I think the second benefit to us is it's a better way of rapidly profiling more samples than the traditional whole genome approaches like exome or whole genome sequencing, which are quite expensive and put them out of reach of not every scientist in the lab. I see the future of NGS oncology as being quite bright. I feel that NGS will be used for all patients to stratify into the right test, stratify into the right drug for the right patient, and by using things like TMB, we can identify patients rapidly for therapies like immunotherapy.